Even for copyright law, that's not, it's under discussion. The law needs to be revised. What we do have is a system in which companies are liable only if they fail to comply with a court order. And regarding fake news, there are over 30 bills of law proposed currently in Brazil that try to criminalize fake news. And actually, a lot of those try to impose the responsibility for deciding what's true and what's not on the platforms. We fight those bills. I don't want to live in a world where Facebook has to decide what's true and what's false. We should not do that. And if you look into Facebook's terms of service and community standards, you will not find a regulation that says you are not allowed to post fake news, because if we were to say that, we would be putting ourselves in that position. The way Facebook works with fake news and disinformation is by working with external fact checkers, and we don't remove the content, we demote the reach that that content gives, and we try to give people more information. So if you, if you choose, for instance, to share an article that has been marked as false by a third-party fact checker, they're all internet nationally audited and certificated by Pointer, then we'll show you a screen that says, look, this article has been marked as false. Are you still sure you wanna spread that? And we find that people, when they have more information, they make better decisions. So no, we do not want to be the arbiters of the truth, for sure.
Thank you. Just perhaps a clarification that it's important to understand the Brazilian scenario regarding fake news and judiciary and law. As different for many countries, in Brazil, the regulation of elections is made by the judiciary. So as you have labor judges, civil law judges, family judges, criminal law judges, there are electoral judges in Brazil. And with the same scheme, you have lower courts, appeal courts, a federal Supreme Court for electoral things, and they are in the same scheme of career. So of course, in that case, it's even more complex, because the judges during the last election, they were actually receiving thousands of requests to take decisions if this is fake news or not fake news. It's not very the same case in other countries, that you have an electoral authority that's not connected with the judiciary power as it is the case in Brazil. From our side as UNESCO and the other co-organizers, we should only thank you very much for being here such late in the night, Thursday. I know you have a party in a few minutes, but I think the amount of people that came during the session, I'm seeing many people here that deals with strategic litigation, jurisdiction issues, lawmakers, the other parts of internet community, which shows that we must continue with this interaction between judges in the internet governance community and other judicial operators. UNESCO will continue with this judges initiative, which is a global program. As Cedric already said, we have been already involved in training 13,000 judicial operators in Latin America, 2,000 in Africa, and the program will be expanded to Asia and to Europe soon. So I hope you, if you are interested, you can join the initiative. I'm sorry I couldn't accept the other questions, but I'm sure the panelists can stay a little bit more if you have some issues to discuss with them. Thank you very much. Have a good evening, and let's keep meeting each other and during IGF.